Hello friends, my name is Vivek and today I'm going to share 240 questions and answers for PL-900 Microsoft Power Platform Fundamentals. The passing score for this exam is 700 out of 1000. The exam fee depends on the country where you live. I'm based in UK, so the exam fee is £69. If you choose different country, for example Thailand, then you only have to pay $55. Now, let's get started with our questions and answers. Question number 1. You need to implement Microsoft Business Applications along with the Microsoft Power Platform. Which three Microsoft products are the part of the Power Platform? Option A, Power Apps. Option B, Azure Active Directory. Option C, Power Automate. Option D, Azure Machine Learning. Option E, Power BI. The correct answers are Option A, Power Apps. Option C, Power Automate. Option E, Power BI. Question number 2. A company has a Power Apps app that is used by most employees. The company is expanding to other countries or regions. You need to recommend a solution to translate text generated within the Power Apps app in the near real time. What should you recommend? Option A, Microsoft Azure Synapse Analytics. Option B, Microsoft Azure Cognitive Services. Option C, Microsoft Dataverse Connector. Option D, Power BI. The correct answer is Option B, Microsoft Azure Cognitive Services. Question number 3. You have a Power Apps app. You create a new version of the app and then publish the new version. A customer goes through the process of restoring the previous version of the app. In the version tab for the app, you will see two versions of the app. Option A, no changes needed. Option B, 1. Option C, 3. Option D, 4. The correct answer is option C, 3. Question number 4. You are building Power Apps app that use both Dynamic 365 Sales and Microsoft 365. For each of the following statement, select yes if the statement is true, otherwise select no. On the left hand side, we have the statement, and on the right hand side, we need to choose either yes or no. The first statement is, Dynamic 365 Sales and Microsoft 365 must be in the same tenant to allow single sign-on, SSO. The correct answer is no. The second statement is, you must download a product from App Source to ensure that SSO works with Dynamic 365 Sales and Microsoft 365. Again, the answer is no. Question number 5. You have version 1.0.0.0 of a published Power Apps app. You create and publish version 2.0.0.0 of the app. A customer goes through the process of restoring the previous version of the app. How many versions of the app are displayed in the version tab for the app? On the bottom, you will see the answer area where you have to choose the correct option. So the correct option is 3. you will see three versions of the app. Question number 6. You are creating a Power Apps app. You want to ensure that the app can be used by individuals who have a vision impairment. For each of the following statement, select yes if the statement is true, otherwise select no. On the left hand side, you will see the statement, and on the right hand side, you need to choose either yes or no. The first statement is, Power Apps can use a screen reader without the need for a connector. And the answer is yes. The second statement is, you can use an accessibility checker for Power Apps app to check for accessibility violation and provide user interface tips. Again, the correct answer is yes. Question number 7. You are the retail director for a large clothing company. Each week, you use the corporate YouTube channel to create a video that highlights new initiatives and goals for retail operations. You need to design a Power Apps app that streams the video to internal users. Which object should you use? On the left hand side, we have some actions, and on the right hand side, we need to choose the correct option. The first action is implement the Power Apps app. The correct option is Canvas. The second action is use drag and drop to add a video to the app. The correct answer is Control. The third action is implement the Power Apps app. And the correct option is Theme. Question number 8. You want to create a Power Apps app that allows you to define a custom sitemap. What should you do? Navigate to the Power Apps portal and create. The correct answer is a model-driven app. Question number 9. You are a sales manager for a large retail organization. You are creating a Power Apps app that will display customer product purchase information from your old point of sale, POS system, and need to link those sales to the customer account and product sales in Dynamic 365 Commerce. You need to use the appropriate component. What should you use? Option A, Microsoft Dataverse. Option B, Business Process Flow. Option C, Entity Metadata. Option D, Business Rule. The correct answer is Option A, Microsoft Dataverse. Question number 10. Your company has an on-prem Microsoft SQL Server database that contains legacy sales data. You must display information from the database in the new Power Apps app. You need to establish a secure connection between the database and the app. What should you use? Option A, Data Source. Option B, App. Option C, Data Gateway. Option D, Power Automate. The correct answer is Option C, Data Gateway.